Hi, everyone. I'm Sheri Hinish, also called the Supply Chain Queen, and I love highlighting supply chains and positive things happening in the world we share. I'm thrilled today to be working with UPS in their Small Biz Spotlights, a series that features businesses who are thriving in the midst of change, like the one we're talking with today, Coolhaus. So let's start with introductions, shall we? Natasha, can you tell us a little bit about your amazing company?
Absolutely. Thanks for having me on. Well, Coolhaus is a women-founded and led, very unique, decadent, delicious ice cream company. We have ice cream sandwiches and pints in both dairy and dairy-free, and we're sold from our flagship store in LA, trucks around the country, and also distributed in about 7,000 grocery stores, from Foods to Ralph's to Publix and Wegmans.
Amazing. And the man who needs no introduction, Chris from UPS.
Thanks so much. Thanks for having me. This is a great opportunity to sit down with one of our very cool customers. So I head up global marketing for UPS, and we operate in 220 countries and territories around the world, working with customers, helping them better serve their customers every day.
So I wanted to start with you, Natasha, and can you tell us a little bit about your business? You operated primarily as a retail business with an events arm prior to COVID. Were you selling online then?
Yeah, we were. We were doing, we do have an online store where we ship out, you know, UPS, Next Ice, all of our prepackaged products and some of the kind of maybe limited time only partnerships that we've done. As a smaller fraction of the business pre-COVID, and, you know, some also on-demand business like ordering on demand from our retail shop or from grocery stores.
Okay. So the pivot to e-commerce, I imagine that it was difficult for you when you had to close some retail operations. What was the first order of business in that critical pivot?
I always, you know, go to my team. I think having a strong team is so, so important. You know, in the good times, you work together, you grow the business, but the toughest moment is really the challenge of a good team. So first looking at, you know, do you have all the right people that are going to be able to wear different hats and do things outside of their comfort zone to survive? And for us, that first, you know, grocery was where we were most leveraged. So we needed to make sure that we could meet the demand, get product to people. But let's also look at the shops and let's look at the events business, as you said, which could not operate even close to how we were. And can we bring that events business to an online experience? Can we ship out a birthday party? Can we ship out a brand partnership to hungry customers around the country? And so, you know, do we have the team that can help set this up quickly and efficiently? And then I think, you know, you get to the product, making sure that you have all the best offerings, that you're doing it in a safe way, and that you're doing it in a way where you can have a strong P&L and survive this.
Yeah, I can't even imagine taking an ice cream business entirely online and the unique challenges that you've been able to navigate. I'm super curious about your process of getting creative and engaging cross-channel. And how do you actually transition to an online experience and some of the things that you've described?
Right. I think, you know, I think you look at the ways you can reach people. That luckily we were diversified with Coolhaus. So we do have the grocery store. So we have the brand awareness. We have the sales. We have the ability to innovate there. And now how do you tailor that experience to what's going to be largely at home consumption? And for me, you know, I started Coolhaus out of the recession. And so I think for me, I really thrive in thinking, okay, how can we be different? How can we get ahead of this curve and really start to not just avoid what's going on, but lean into it and thrive in that? And, you know, looking at something like e-com, okay, well, before we could only go to people's birthday parties, let's say when they lived in the LA, New York, or Dallas area where we have trucks. Now, can we create a birthday experience online, you know, with the cookies and the ice cream, with custom flavors that we can create in our innovation center in Culver City, with the edible wrappers that we serve the ice cream sandwiches in that can have custom, you know, phrases on them or pictures of the birthday boy or girl, whoever? Can we ship that out? And can people kind of maybe have that in their homes? Can they have a Zoom party where they're all eating it together and can they feel united? You know, so I think that's a way to think about not only, okay, now we can still do a birthday party, but now we can do that birthday party for anywhere in the country. It's not just where we have trucks. And maybe we can even grow the business that way.
Chris, I'm curious, can you share a little bit about maybe what you're hearing from the provider side? Are there any lessons learned maybe you can share that UPS has seen?
Yeah, I think they're right along the lines of what Natasha was talking about, in that small and medium-sized companies are using this time to pivot and really prepare their business for the new normal or the next normal. And whether it's ways to get more eyeballs with social, kind of working on their websites and design, the core product and innovation, and lastly, you know, getting it to the customers where they are in new channels, in new ways. It's all those things, but companies are also finding that doing those things are not only preparing for the future, but helping them right now. And I saw the quote, hey, 3 years of progress in the last 3 months. And I think we're seeing that all over the place, especially with a company like Coolhaus.
UPS has been supporting SMBs for a really long time. And I'm curious, what are you hearing from your customers and how are you incorporating that feedback into your services offering?
You know, the first thing we heard from customers, help us with information. You know, what's going on in and around the economy? What can you help us in terms of pivoting our business with the solutions that you have? So we started to do things like we hosted webinars. We brought virtual consultations, which are still available to do one-on-one dialogues with customers. So the first kind of phase was, can you help me with some more information? And then we've moved in over the last month or so really into enabling our customers to transition into the world that we live in right now. And that along the lines that came with better visibility tools. So I may not be at my office as much anymore. How will I know exactly when my driver is going to come to pick up or maybe drop off? And so we have a solution called My Choice for Business that enables that greater level of visibility. For example, we have a tool called Smart Pickups. So customers that may not be shipping as often anymore don't need a driver to come each and every day. So a Smart Pickup just enables that service provider to come when there's a pickup. We have different warehousing options. We have e-fulfillment, where to go, kind of the Airbnb of warehousing. And these are all solutions that have really seen a big uptick based on where we are right now.
It's really just so, you know, edifying to learn about these resources, because we've struggled a lot in the past when we've done events in cities where they're not our home. You know, like we've taken our trucks on like multi-city tours handing out ice cream, and you can't fit all of it on the truck. Where is it going to live, when you need to go and pick up more? So knowing that, you know, there's Airbnb of warehousing would be huge for us. I think about obviously how that could help in the past, but if I think about even this situation we're now in the future, we're looking at, you know, the cloud kitchen model where we can have like pop-up retail in different cities, but it's really only a warehouse that you ship out from that can be ordered with on-demand ordering and fulfillment. Or maybe there's just a concentration of customers in an area for an activation. Maybe we need a temporary warehouse in that city so we can ship out from there instead of shipping across the country necessarily every time. So I think it's great to know about these strategies, and it will certainly help us, you know, as things continue to pivot coming out of this change.
So Natasha, Coolhaus is really good at telling brand stories and making that human connection. Think about what the world looks like in the next 6 to 12 months. Can you share with listeners a message of inspiration, any key advice that you would give them as they're also navigating the storm?
Yeah, I would tell any listeners, you know, in every way, think of this as an opportunity. Some of the greatest, you know, brands and businesses that we know come out of the most challenging times. So think of how you can, you know, in a way, capitalize on thinking about your business differently, pivoting, leaning in to more of a growth channel, and just make sure, however you do that, it reflects your passions and what brings you joy with the business. Because if you're going to work really, really hard at anything, you better make sure you love what you're doing. So I think with those two things together, that's your best chance for success.
Natasha, Chris, thank you so much for sharing stories of inspiration today. There are positive and amazing things happening in supply chain. And thank you, UPS, for helping all the SMBs thrive in the midst of change. All the best, everyone. And thanks for tuning in.
Thank you.